So, man, this is so cool. We're in Malta. We're coming to this trail, and I have actually been trying to see if I can find a hedgehog, and I come up over this hill, and what do I see? A chameleon. Look at how fast he's moving. Wow, look at that. Isn't that so cool? Look at that. He's not as aggressive as I would have assumed. People who keep chameleons as pet are actually more aggressive, and he's wild. That's insane. He actually, if you look at the landscape, he matches it very well. He's very bright green, and you can see all the yellow flowers. Look at how dark he is on this side. But he's incredibly calm. Rachel's being the realist and pointing out that we probably shouldn't be handling this wild animal.
Look at how he's holding on to that. Oh, they're so cool.
Yep.
That's such a neat creature.
Isn't that amazing? Look at him against that blue water back there.
His eye, man, he's so cool.
All right, guys, I'm going to put him down. Don't chew me out for picking him up. Sorry. Let's let him go on his way. He was just crossing the road here. There he goes. So we're out again today trying to find something to do since the lockdown has closed all of the tourist sites basically and left us with the option to go to the beach or go to a trail, which is fine with us. We're actually here today and we found this trail here, Marfa Ridge Walk. We had actually come here the other day. There's a cave over there. We'll go check that out in a second. Maybe you can see the top of it there, but they call that Climber's Cave. You'll see why when we get over there. But we came the other day and the wind was so strong that it was just not very enjoyable. But we're gonna head down this trail now and we'll show you guys as we go along the beautiful scenery here. Is this some time? Nope. So as we go along, oh, here's some time.
No, I don't think so. Yep, that's
yeah,
time.
For sure. You can tell how like rugged and rough the plant is.
Oh, it smells so good.
Right? So we're gonna head down this trail. There's actually a really neat natural arch down here and a really neat trail as you go down. Actually, as I come just to the edge of the cliff here, you can see that there is a huge crack in this rock. It's insane. Look at this. So that will eventually, I'm assuming, crack and just fall down there. So it looked as if these stairs were going to lead us right down, but as I get a little further, it looks like it's about to get a little rough, but I think it's going to be pretty neat. If you look here, it just kind of goes right into this brush here underneath those trees. Hopefully it's not too overgrown and we can make our way through there pretty easily. I guess we'll find out here soon enough, but that's part of the whole fun, I guess, doing a little bushwhacking. Too bad we don't have a machete. It looks like there's some kind of writing on this step here, but I couldn't be sure. I did notice actually a couple times that there was etching on the rocks, and I'm assuming that was for like a non-slip grip. Whoa, check this out. Hopefully it winds through here pretty good, I guess. And we don't come to a dead end.
It's so charming in here.
Yeah, it's really neat, huh?
All the, especially with the trees in bloom, it's beautiful.
I never thought actually from the top that it would turn into this little path. It just looked like a bunch of stones that kind of led down to the sea. But it came right through here, and that's pretty cool. So check out these massive slabs that have just broken off from that coastline, or at least that cliff there, and have just tumbled down. Like, look at this. Imagine that was standing strong at one point, and like everything else, it's just collapsed. And it's just that would have been the top, the flat portion that you could have walked on. But we're making our way down to the beautiful arch there. And I'm assuming once we get down there, there's going to be some very beautiful waters. Well, I have to definitely recommend if you're coming to Malta, bring some good hiking shoes and enjoy these trails, because the water isn't exactly warm enough to get in right now. So we haven't ventured into the sea, especially today. It was raining yesterday, so today it's only
like 61 degrees Fahrenheit. So to come out on a trail and have something to do, and the trail's beautiful, and there's certainly no lack of nice scenery here. So I certainly recommend it. Rachel wanted me to point out that we are on the main island. You can actually see the second largest island from here, which is Gozo, just across there. So we've made it down here to the sea, and as you can see, there's some boathouses here. I'm not sure if people are staying in that one. It looks like there's something outside, but the other one looks like it's collapsed. Looks kind of like a dangerous place because that rock looks pretty precarious there. But look at this beautiful natural arch here. It reminds me of that large one that's here that collapsed. Mm-hmm. Let's go down and see if we can get a closer look. So it looks like there's actually quite a few boat storages here. Maybe some are abandoned. That one actually looks empty. And these other ones are locked up. And then there's this one here. But then you would just take your boat right out of your little storage unit here. And look how convenient this is. Boom, right here, right into this beautiful Mediterranean Sea. Look at how clear that water is. Isn't this so beautiful? This water is insane. I don't know if we can get across these rocks over, and we'll try and get underneath there. There's a really neat chunk of some type of mineral here. I thought at first maybe it was salt, but maybe quartz or something. We hopped up on these. Oh, that one would have taken us out good. That one went up high. Water's coming up a little bit more now. So we got a little closer. I bet we could make it even further just up along these rocks. They're almost volcanic looking, aren't they?
They absolutely are.
Man, these waves are getting a little heavier on us here. Let's see if we can get a good one again. There we go. Thankfully, we've got the high ground, and it looks like the backpack's safe for now. But this arch has a little mini arch, and imagine the sea's gonna break that down, and this is just gonna collapse even more. Basically, it looks like three sections. There's this section, that big middle section, and then those sections over there. So this will eventually, as nature does, take itself back and just become a part of the sea. Check this out, there's a vein of quartz right here. How freaking cool is that? It just keeps going. There's like pockets. Isn't that freaking awesome? Man, I hope that's focusing. That's the neatest cluster right there. I've never seen a vein of a crystal like that.
Way freaking cool.
Well, we haven't been brave enough to submerge ourselves yet. But we figured since we came over here and it was such a beautiful day that we better take a dip in this beautiful water. But like I said, we haven't submerged just yet. We've just gotten about knee deep in this gorgeous crystal clear water. So who knows, maybe we'll feel brave here in a second. There's a deeper spot just here I'm trying to make my way to, but I don't know. I don't know, man. Look at that, it's so welcoming. I just can't bring myself to do it.
Watch out, I'm doing it.
All right, she's going for it.
Come on.
How is it?
Oh, but it's so worth it. Come on.
Here, look, you want me to take your sandies? Oh. All right, let me get these sandals. Got them. Sandy collection complete. She's always the brave one. She always goes first. All right, let me take mine off. I almost feel like the ground is more grippy with my bare feet. I think there's a little stairs here.
Oh,
it's so cold. I'm going under.
Yeah.
Woo! Oh, not so bad once you submerge your whole body and your head.
Oh, I better get my head.
Yeah, you gotta do it.
Okay, ready?
Yep.
It's so buoyant.
Huh? Oh. Man, there's this neat spot around the corner. I hate to venture around too far because I don't want to step on something silly, but...
And the waves are hitting the rocks a little hard, so I don't want to venture too far and get crushing the rocks. Yeah.
Right? Oh, I think I'm just going to stand here for a second. Look at this water. Look at how clear that is. Oh, it's so clear.
I've been so scared to stand.
You gotta just find a big rock. They're pretty chunky rocks, but...
Right? And this little seaweed stuff is actually kind of...
creepy?
Kind of creepy, but it's... This one's... I got a squishy one.
Here comes a big wave. Woo! All right, I think Rachel figured it out. You just gotta float and let the waves take you in and out. Now there's no waves, huh?
Right.
She was going back and forth pretty good there for a second.
It was a lot of fun. And then you don't have to worry about balancing or if you're going to step on a hard rock or soft rock.
Or something poisonous.
Yeah.
There she goes.
You can tell we're desert dwellers. We're so excited by these little waves.
You know, it's funny too because I don't see any natives in this water. No, we're the first people I've seen in the water since we got here for sure. Well, I have to say after being in here for, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes, your body acclimates pretty well. It was only supposed to be like 61 degrees today. And the water, after you're in here for a bit, it actually feels pretty good. I think Rachel's having way too much fun.
I love it. The time of my life.
She's
it's
just
so
floating back and forth.
Square feet of an area, but I don't care. It's amazing.
My phone is water resistant. I'm tempted to dip it underwater, but I'm not going to because that would be a terrible idea. But I'm just standing on this rock that's covered in some type of vegetation growth, and it's pretty cool. And then I've just been jumping right into this deeper spot, but I wanted to. Don't die. I wanted to grab the camera and come get a view of this little deeper spot. It's so beautiful. I wanted to go back there, but the shadow makes the bottom really dark, so you can't really see. But it looks really calm, actually. If you had some like goggles and a snorkel, it'd probably be super awesome back there. Well, did you have fun?
A million times, yes. Absolutely, it was amazing.
We've wrapped up our swim, and we're gonna dry out a bit. And head up this trail. There's this really neat archway doorway over here that I saw the other day. We're gonna try to find our way up through it, and then we'll walk over to that climber's cave, and I'll show you that. So if you, you're a climber wanting to do some climbing, this will interest you. It's really neat, actually. Well, we've come up off the trail that took us down to that arch after our swim. It was very lovely, but I wanted to show you a bit of this landscape here. We've actually just parked just a bit over there, and you can see there's just all types of rock walls and small rock huts, but that cave is just over here. But just straight ahead of us is this really neat archway door that I believe leads down to another trail. So we're heading towards this little archway I was telling you about, and look at this set of stairs that's carved right into this stone. Let's go check it out. So that was a pretty wicked set of stairs that was carved into there. I'm not sure how old any of this is, but it certainly
I would say maybe a couple thousand years old, the way the stairs have eroded, and then this just kind of leads down. Wow, there's another big chunk of minerals here. Looks like maybe some more quartz or something there. So I'm thinking that ribbon's telling us to go this way, but that arch doorway is just there. You can see the trail that leads down here. It's built up with all these stones. It's really neat. This landscape's far out. It looks like where they filmed like the old Planet of the Apes. But look at this just drop off, and this rock just wedged between these two larger rocks is the trail. You gotta kind of walk just over here, and then you'll see there's a set of stairs. So here's the climber's cave I was telling you. We're gonna go down in there. Actually, from here it doesn't look like it, but just over there, if you can see Rachel, there's actually a like a ramp of stairs, basically like the other trail heads that we've been on. There is basically an ancient set of stairs. So let's head over there and we'll go down in there and we'll show you guys the all the different climbing points. So as we head down in here, I noticed there was a sign. It says, "How to preserve Latniha Cave. Don't litter, including toilet paper." And then followed by, "Don't pee or poop inside the cave." And then it says, "Don't set any fires close to the rock walls. Be respectful of others and the environment around you. Take only memories and leave only footprints." Unfortunately, I can see already that not a lot of people are abiding by those rules.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Right. But let's go down here and check out these trees. I think those ones look like they might be almonds and figs. Just away from the climbing points here actually is a couple trees. It's pretty neat. I walked over here and these are actually almond trees. I don't know if you've ever seen a almond growing, but basically that's it there. And then inside of that is the almond that would be growing. So this is an almond tree here. That one's an almond tree. This is an almond tree. That's an almond tree. And this is a fig tree. So that's really neat that these plants are growing down in here. I wonder if that's an almond tree as well, that bigger one.
Right, it certainly could be.
Yeah, it's really cool. Look, there's another fig tree, but this sign over here is pretty funny. It has women and men going to the bathroom. Must be the spot where people would go to urinate or defecate. Or maybe it's just saying in general, don't do that down here. Let's head over here and actually I'll show you these climbing points. Oh, is that the raw almond, mm-hmm. Huh?
That's what it looks like inside.
Some cyanide. Crazy, man.
Pretty neat.
So if you can see, these climbers have come and just rigged a whole bunch of points in here so that you can come down in here and really just practice your climbing skills. We came the other day and there was a couple down in here and they were attaching themselves and climbing up these really awesome walls. Look back in there, there's like a nice little cove. This would be a really neat spot to actually come down in here and camp. Yeah, it looks like there's several. See, here's another one.
Oh, yeah.
But where's some harnesses here? So there's a few up there. I don't know if you can see them, the little colored ones. They're a bunch of carabiners essentially attached to the rock face there.
You can see them maybe there hanging against like against the light.
Yeah, for sure. It's really neat. There's a, looks like a point, a climbing point here that they've pointed out to start climbing up. To attach yourself there to the first carabiner. It's really a neat little cave. And if you had some time, you could probably camp out for the night if you were a climber and, you know, maybe come in the evening and then do some climbing. I'm not sure the significance of this wall, if maybe this was actually a whole, like, building built into here. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
And it's just collapsed. But looking up out of here, you can see it's just a, it was probably an underground cave and then the ceiling collapsed, or the roof collapsed, and just left you with this wide open portion here. It's really neat, and if you're in the area, you should definitely come check it out, because this is all, this little trip that we just took is all right here, and you can either start at Climber's Cave and go down, or you can start down there and head over to Climber's Cave. You'll see it once you pull in. There's actually just a real small
basically one-lane road, and at the end there's several parking spots. In the high season, it's probably crazy over here, but there's no one here today. We only passed like one other couple. But I just wanted to show you guys this cave before we ended the video. I appreciate you guys coming along. And stay safe, you guys, and stay sane out there.